How many know we're in a spiritual warfare? The Bible clearly indicates you and I are not fighting against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against world rulers in heavenly places. Ephesians chapter 6 says we are in a spiritual war. 2 Corinthians 10 says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. You and I are in a war. The war is raging all around us. It's a spiritual war. But it says, regarding a good soldier, no one entangles himself in the affairs of this life. He does not get entangled in the affairs of this life if you're engaged in a war, so that he can please the one who enlisted him. Now, you and I have been, in a sense, we have been enlisted. One time, there was a draft. When I was in college, they had what they called the draft. The draft was, if your number came up, you went. Now, there were those that had exemptions. There were those that could not physically. But if you were drafted, you were drafted. That meant they took you. Whether you wanted to go or not, you had to show up at the Selective Service Office. You had to show up and do your part. That was the draft. Then we've gone to an all-volunteer army. So today, everyone who enlists is in a volunteer. They don't and aren't required to. But in the kingdom of God, I think that the kingdom of God is a combination of both draft and volunteer. First of all, God chose you. Hallelujah. Say, God chose me. God chose you. He chose you. He, in a sense, drafted you. But then what do you have to do? After he drafts you, you have to say, oh, I volunteer. I'll go. Hallelujah. In other words, you have to respond to his drafting.